Alright, so I got the fender off on that side. That was kind of a pain. I'm going to go ahead and get started on the parts car here. I'm going to get everything that I can removed out of it. And then after everything's ready, I'll push the car back and get the cherry picker in here and yank this engine out and transmission. And we'll get started doing that. And I was going to do a time-lapse video like I usually do. But this is going to take a little bit longer than normal because it's cold out. I have the heater going. And I have to constantly run back and forth because kids are being a pain today. It's Christmas, so they feel like they can act up for some reason. So I'm going to go ahead and get started doing this. I'm going to tear into it, and I'll skip forward to me actually pulling the motor out for you so that you don't have to watch the boring stuff. I know some of you like the boring stuff and some of you don't. But basically, I'm just going to unbolt everything, pull it out, and go from there. So let's get started. So we got the engine and transmission out, as you just seen. It overall looks good. I just went through and looked it all over. Everything's looking pretty good inside. And, oils. I mean, I drove it in here. It runs perfect. But I have some parts I'm going to throw onto it before it goes into the car. There's also something to note. If you guys are doing the auto to manual swap, you're going to want to be sure to get the bracket that goes right here from the manual car, because the automatic one doesn't bolt to the transmission. Good news is you don't have to buy special mounts to put the 5-speed in the auto. On the 96 to 2000, make a note of that. The 96 2000's the only one you don't have to buy special mounts for, because the mounts are all the same. It's just the bracket that's different. Keep the rear T-bracket from the manual transmission as well, because you're gonna need that. Get the clutch master cylinder, clutch slave cylinder, all the clutch slave cylinder line. You'll want to grab the clutch pedal. Some people prefer to do brake, gas, clutch. I've done it a few times where I just use the clutch pedal and then I use a grinder and cut the brake pedal smaller. That way you're not get this long automatic pedal and it's real close to the clutch pedal. So what you're going to want to do is, if you want to do it the right way, I recommend pulling clutch, brake, gas pedal out of the manual car. Like I said, it's not a necessity, but it's more convenient and makes it look like it came factory that way. Also, if you want, grab the gauge cluster out of the manual, so on and so forth. Basically, all you're gonna need is the linkages. If you want, grab the center console that already has the 5-speed shift bag, all that good stuff, if you have a full parts car. If not, you're gonna have to piece this together. There'll be a video completely, entirely on how to do the auto to manual swap. So I will get started pulling some of this out. Go in and have myself a nice drink. Probably relax, because I have not had time to relax. So I appreciate all your views, guys. I appreciate all your comments, all your support. There'll definitely be more videos. Just keep watching, keep updated on the channel. If you haven't, go back and watch some of my old videos, because every time you watch a video, you help me financially. And the financial help from you guys will help fund this quicker. I have the money. I have paid my attorney, and I bought $1,000 worth of parts. I got a Skunk 2 manifold used, but I got a PLM, I don't know, some kind of, I call it the squiggly header, the race header. It's better than the normal, typical eBay header. Since I'm doing the all motor, I got the Yanaka Catback exhaust, 2.5 inch. It's more than enough for an all motor D. I got a Stage 3 racing cam. I'm excited about that. I will have details of me putting it in. I will do my best to help you guys understand. And I'm going to do my best to understand myself, because I'm still kind of new to the camshaft game. I put a few in before, but I never dialed them in. This one won't be dialed in, unfortunately, right away. I won't have the money for a Hondata S300, because the guy that I got these cars from needed a little bit of extra cash, and yeah, so I helped him out, and my buddy who helped me get these. So yeah, we're gonna get some stuff done on this channel, so definitely stay tuned. There's lots of things coming. I still haven't come up with a color scheme. I don't know if you guys knew this. I probably didn't show you, but the inside of the headliner is Ninja Turtle. Like, the entire thing is Ninja Turtle. And my kids absolutely love it. They want me to paint the car lime green and do the engine bay yellow so it looks like a Ninja Turtle. And I love lime green. You know me. But I don't know if I want to do it. What's your guys' thoughts? What do you think I should do color-wise? Because I'm still going to be doing Rust-Oleum. For all the haters out there, yes, I'll still be doing spray cans, whatever. But I'm going to shoot clear for sure this time over it. Not that it had anything to do bad with the other. I mean, it turned out fantastic, still holding up to this day. But I want to do something different. And if I do a matte color, I will be shooting a matte clear over it. So thanks for watching the video. I'm rambling on. You guys are probably getting bored and tired and ready to close out of the video. So definitely let me know what you guys think. I will be doing high comp. It's a Y8, so it has a little bit higher compression than all the other D-series out there. It's closest to the A6, but I know so much about the internals and the compression ratios on this thing, it's ridiculous. But I'll do the best I can to keep you updated on every single thing I do. As soon as those parts get in the mail, you'll be the first to know. Well, second, because I'll be the first to know, and then you will be. So I will definitely keep you guys updated. So stay tuned to the channel. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, share if you haven't. Just keep being awesome. You guys are the best subscribers of any channel could ever ask for. You guys communicate with me and let me know things here and there. I mean, I'm still learning. I'm not a know-it-all by any means, but I'm still taking input. There are things that I know that a few of my subscribers have brought to me, and I'm not the kind of guy saying, I already knew that. But, you know, one of those things that you just take the advice as you go along the way. So thanks for watching. I really appreciate your views. So hit that like button.